wrestler. We're drawing at random for 16 random tag teams. 8 tag team matches. They don't know their partner. They may not like their partner. They may love their partner. Regardless, they have a common goal. And that goal is to be one of the winners. There will be 8 tag team winners. 16 men.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Lethal Lottery was held exactly 45 minutes ago. The results were handed to JB Elementary. He's the only gentleman in the building who knows who's partnered with who. So let's all find out who's in match number one.
Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready for Battle Bowl, the Lethal Lottery? One more time, ladies and gentlemen, I said, are you
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome, welcome, welcome to PWA Championship Wrestling here in Carrollton, Georgia. Along with Robert Slay and the Commissioner Shane Knows, I am Tony the Cobra Calhoun, and we're glad to be in this house tonight. Battle Bowl!
Yes, super glad, Tony, and it's great to be with you in this PWA. First time I've been back in a long time, and I got to tell you, Tony, I am glad to be back on the side like tonight.
Yes, sir. We're glad to be here with Shane Knows. As soon as we get him in, we'll have everything ready for him.
Thank you.
Let's welcome to the table the Commissioner Shane Knowles.
Good to be here with South.
His tag team partner from Atlanta, Georgia, Stitch Sober.
Good to be here with Bert and Cobra. JB was putting over all eight tag team matches tonight. Have a 15-minute time limit. There will be no additional time granted. We must have a winner. Out of the eight tag team matches, there will be eight tag teams. 16 wrestlers who will make it to the two-ring battle bowl, double elimination match for the chance to be the new champion.
Yes, sir. We got Nigel. We got Stupid. We got Caden Knight?
Caden Knight with Nigel Sherrod, yes, Stitch.
And Stitch Cypher.
Creates all kinds of random unpredictability, Cobra, and none of these gentlemen know who their partner is until they hit the ring. Just as surprised as the fans are, as I said in the ring, you may not like your partner, you may love him, you may not even know him, but you have a common goal. You have to win your tag team match to make it to Battle Bowl, where it's every man for himself to be the new champion.
Yes, sir, you can believe that, what's going to happen.
Stupid, as always, accompanied by the lovely students. Referee for this match is Bristol Romaine. Nigel Sherrod, a fan favorite, but Stitch Cypher rising ranks here in the PWA after a fantastic 20-minute bout 2 weeks ago against Black Baron.
Are you there, Bert? No.
If you're watching the DVD, we apologize for any technical difficulties we may have right now. Three men in the booth.
Well, Mr. Noe, we thank you for coming in and helping us commentate while we try to get these technical difficulties out of the way.
As if I wasn't long-winded enough.
Yeah, now we might be around to some wrestling action now.
As a commissioner, you've got to do it all, and we do appreciate it. And I wanted to thank you for having us to come this way. And I think you're saying it's going to be a nice little memory, and I saw all the things here, but I think
this is a record-setting night for the people who are on the crowd on hand as you look out through the venue. One man out of 32 will be the new PWA Heritage Champion when the dust settles and smoke clears this evening.
Well, Shane, tell us pretty much how that come about, you know, because last week it was Crew Jones was your Heritage Champion, am I right?
Crew Jones has been the Heritage Champion since August 20th. He held the title. However, due to a series of incidents over the last three or four shows, Crew Jones was stripped of the title by myself. I hated to do that. This Battle Bowl deal was actually, when it was conceived, it was supposed to be 32 men.
Oh my God, he hit him.
This was supposed to be 32 men with an opportunity to be the number one contender for the PWA Heritage title. However, due to the length of Jones doing those actions, he was stripped of the title, and this was made one night. One new champion. Crew Jones has just as good a chance as anyone else. However, there are 31 people with an opportunity.
Oh, that's a nice kick by Nigel. Stick Stifle, yeah, like you say, he's an up-and-coming new guy here in PWA.
Impressed the fans with a series of aerial maneuvers, one like that right there. Almost like a head scissors squash takedown. Maneuver. Nigel Shore, his first PWA appearance since November.
He dropped Ben right down on the throat for him.
Stifle may be about to go airborne here. Oh, one shot into a double leg drop to the afternoon of Mr. Al.
That's him. As you did mention, we have Tweety on the outside, the constant companion of Stupid, who has just been tagged in.
A lot of fans here don't like Tweety, and can you blame him? She's what we call a pest, a nuisance.
Yes, I can understand that.
See there, nice spin of head kick there. Elbow drop for a two count. Once again, we all get to see how Nigel Shorati is very resilient inside that ring.
Stupid guaranteeing that Nigel going to go to sleep here.
Nigel with a super hold, made famous by many a former wrestler. Once you get a light in up under the chin, that's not a chokehold. It is very devastating.
You know, it's going to be hard for these guys to work together, you know, especially when they just, you know, been picked out of the clear blue sky, who, you know, but they got to work together in order to get to where they need to be.
Double clothesline right there. It's both men are down.
Yeah, how do you prepare for something like this? Because you don't know your opponent's strengths and weaknesses, let alone your own tactics.
Yeah, Shane, I just can't imagine the behind the locker room scene out there as each one has to kind of, you know, fill out each other. Because, like I said, 32 people out there, break down tag teams. You got to look around and see who you can trust and make it through the first match. No matter as the night goes on, trust factor is going to go away.
Right, going out the window, Bert, when we get to Battle Bowl, the 16-man double elimination Battle Royal, city man for himself.
Oh, spine buster right in the middle of the ring, going over for a cover.
That's a save.
That's one way to make a save.
Well, you know, I'm going to tell you like this, with me, I would need to be in there helping myself, because if you don't help yourself, it's going to be some problems.
That's it right there. As he goes over for a cover, puts it for a leg, only gets a two count.
You got Nigel over here on the ground with with Stupid getting in the business.
Going airborne here.
Oh.
And this is a big splash. Seth Knight takes a call.
Oh, a
man, he went through him. Oh.
And I thought we had our first man event.
2 minutes on the match, 5 minutes remaining. Tian Yong, 5 remaining.
What a fantastic opening out here in the Lethal Lottery. If this is a precursor to what's to come, we are definitely in for one historic night for the PWA.
Uh-oh. Nice move. Did you see that?
Whoa.
Look at that. Pop! That's all I can say is pop.
Every time Stick Slash is here, he brings out something new in his repertoire. He's setting up the big man here.
Oh, that was close.
That's insult to Adrian.
Once again on that top row.
Joe, and knees right here. Horse and leg. It gets a three count.
Stupid and
Stick Cypher are the first two gentlemen. They're the first two wrestlers who advance to the Battle Bowl.
And this, of course, going to be a night of nonstop action. Those two did get a chance to get a breather. That's one thing you have to be prepared to be the first man out. But once you get the first man out, you have a chance to catch a breath. Maybe that is the advantage that they need.
This point, Greg, you know, if you're on first, you know, you're going to have at least an hour and a half rest advantage over everyone else by the time it comes to the main event.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, Stick Cypher and Super will advance to Battle Bowl.
Yeah.
appearance in PWA. I think there were 15 guys on the card this evening that have never wrestled for PWA, and however their first night in, they, just as well as ones that are regulars on the active roster, will get an opportunity to become the new PWA Heritage Champion.
Ladies and gentlemen, your partner from Atlanta, Georgia, Andy Anderson.
Is that Sting's son?
He's a little short on the hair in the back, but
yeah, he looks
a nice resemblance. But going back to the new competition here in PWA, and of course Shane. It's great for the fans because you get to see new talent. And once again, it shows these wrestlers, these competitors, that you can go into any promotion and come away on top.
That's true. You know, this is great for the fans to see this collection of talent under one roof for one night only. 32 professional wrestlers. Dare I say it, we've actually got two. Well, I shouldn't say that. There's actually 32 professional wrestlers each year for WWE. There won't be 32 in the actual Battle Bowl main event. However, 32 do have an opportunity. There will be no ring announcers entering the fray unless Coach is working boots on.
No, I think I'll pass tonight.
His bag is behind us.
But, you know. I always carry my stuff, you know.
Yeah. Considering that I don't have a list of people, Cobra, your name could be on here. You've got the whole slide granted.
Well, you know.
Bert seems to have sniffed it out.
Well, you know, Shane, I didn't put my name in, but somebody might have.
There's always an emergency wrestler. Something could go bad in the back. As you see, Austin taking the control inside the ring.
This house is packed, Mr. Knowles.
Very good crowd here. By the time everyone filters in, it could be standing room only. There's a 500-seat capacity for this building. I still see some chairs unoccupied. That may not hold too for long. As you see, Joey Sartain working on the left shoulder of CJ Austin.
I think those empty seats are there for a reason. People are standing in anticipation for what's going to happen.
Good point. Now, Bert, I got a question. It's been a while since you've been to PWA. Are we going to see you in the Lethal Lottery? Are you one of the two competitors here this evening?
No, sir. I don't like their odds. If I join in, I don't like their odds at all. But I think it would be a foot race between me and the Cobra over there to the ring.
Glad to have all of you watching on the DVDs here with us on Southland Sports TV. I'd like to thank them for their dynamite coverage of the Peach State Wrestling Alliance here at the VFW Fairgrounds in Charleston, Georgia.
We're glad to be here. I'm glad to have Bert back. But I still don't like him. I just wanted Chip to know that. I mean,
welcome back with open arms, but you're not fond of him.
No, not fond of him at all. That's when you're in the middle.
There's a lot of tension between the guys. There's a lot of tension in this building, period. 32 guys. You see Dark Star and Gil Rivera on the action here. 32 guys are at their peak because they know tonight, one chance, one shot.
It was a nice short clothesline by Austin there, followed up by a couple stomps. And I must say, one of my favorite wrestlers, the hometown, is always from Unknown.
Parts Unknown has produced a lot of great professional wrestlers over the years. However, it doesn't seem to show up on the GPS system.
Outdated machines.
But it's a mystery about being from places from Unknown. And my good friend, you know, he ran Carrollton when he was over here, so he was the Carrollton Dragon. You remember him saying?
That name certainly rings a bell. I was hoping his name would not be brought up tonight. There's been much speculation with Carrollton Dragon, if you call him Cobra, Ultimate Dragon. A lot of speculation as to who all would be here tonight, and I told him there's only one way to find out. Be here.
That's right. This is a come and see show. You come and you'll see. Crowd getting into the action.
Andy Anderson, huh?
tights and there was the boots.
The build is definitely there. But the resemblance of Sting with Andy Anderson, would it be awful if I just call him Double A for short?
Now, I don't think you want to do the Double A thing. I don't think Arn Anderson would be liking that one.
Yeah, Arn still, I think, has a residence not too far up the road in Rome, Georgia. I definitely don't want to feel the wrath of his spine buster. You
know,
no. For copyrighting things.
Yeah.
We could call him a Sting lookalike. We could call him Double A. But by the end of the night, we could be calling Andy Anderson the EPWA Heritage Champion. You just never know. I really thought about doing this. Gambling is illegal in Georgia, setting up a wheel. 32 guys and letting the crowd kind of hedge their bets on who they thought would be the champion at the end of the night. But, you know, and the format, we're probably going to talk about it to death. You know, it doesn't matter how good you are. It's how good your partner is and willing to work with you. Some of the biggest names here tonight and some of the best wrestlers may not even make the final 16.
See Anderson with a drop kick.
That's a big man.
Oh, wow.
He didn't feel.
That was a reverse Ric Flair flop.
Yeah, he's confused.
Probably we talk about it. That concrete, the cement, is not made of barbecue sauce. It doesn't taste good.
And it don't feel good at all.
Playing possum though is Dark Star. Is this another neck breaker?
This is the house that the neck breaker built.
That's been a recurring
thing.
It's a save by Awesome right there.
Well, Bert, we have a saying in PWA the last three or four shows that you either have to win by, or you have to have a neck breaker going on in your match, or what else was it? Was it?
Oh, the, swinging neck breaker.
Swing, yeah.
Or the Los Trios, suplex.
Yes.
Whoever wants to do threes, comes in threes, a la Eddie Guerrero.
Sartain and Austin are awesome running off at the mouth with Dark Star, and Mr. Anderson seems to be taking the blunt of all this punishment.
Mr. Anderson. Mr. What is calling Andy? Of course, you know, Mayberry may come calling.
Yes, sir.
He's going to get you in a whole heap of trouble.
I'm telling you.
Might need to rethink him bringing him back.
This Andy Anderson looks like somebody. He's got a name like two people. Wrestles like three others.
That's right.
Add it all up. It's a deadly combination. Time closing in here in contest number two. And the Lethal Lottery. The Lethal Lottery round has got it right.
See Dark Star right there. Just jumping on his back.
That's a whole lot of man in spandex. I'm scared of it. It's raining outside.
Yeah, it's just raining men.
I'm going to have to leave you guys alone.
Bert may have to take a breather here.
But it is great to be back. And, Shane, I noticed you in the ring and showing everybody the PWA Heritage Champion title belt. And you was behind us earlier, right before we had some technical difficulties. I was kind of hoping to bring it over and then try it on. That way I know in the next matchup, maybe you give old Bert a call.
Maybe Bert would like to enter a PWA ring. Maybe we could set that up.
I see a Bert versus Cobra.
I was going to say, maybe you could do
Dover clothesline.
Time closing in, I was going to say Bert could actually do the old Jesse Ventura deal. He might could broadcast his entire mouth. Cobra may have something to say about that.
Yeah. He'll be all right.
See both men struggling to get up right in the middle of the ring. Awesome and Dark Star is desperate to get in to get this match going because, like, the two men in the ring, the two men on the apron wants to get in as well. And that's a tag, but that's a tag you don't want to receive from your partner.
All right, but it's remaining. back right hand. He
don't seem to like Dog Star, does he?
Suplex followed by one count. And Anderson got a whole lot of money with this.
Wow.
He's firing up.
He gets tagged in by Awesome on his back. He didn't notice it.
I was going to say, I thought we might see some of that tonight. People tagging, you know, running their own shot at Glory.
Oh, a little power slam. One, two, and that's a three count.
Wow.
Andy Anderson and Awesome move on through the night. Of course, we talked about this earlier, your tag team partners now, but I think that's something Andy Anderson's going to remember, getting tagged out of this match.
Yes.
And just because we don't want to make any ring here jealous, we are going to back and forth method, which I always enjoy.
Match number three.
Favorite, ain't it?
Rock Storm, yes, we already have four advanced to Battle Bowl. Just a reminder, Stick Cypher, Speaker, Andy Anderson, and CJ Awesome. First tag team in match number three, Stanley Somerville, and the local scene, Josh Storm.
Well, let me tell you something. Excitement is not the only thing in the air. I do smell popcorn, but talking about, you know, fan favorites, local fanfare, Stanley Somerville, I grew up with him.
You grew up with who?
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing one of their opponents from Washington. one half of the Washington Bullets, Trent Williams. And his partner,
oh, wow. Wow. Wow, one of the exotic ones is going to be partnered with Trey Williams of the Washington Bullets. These two involved in a hit. Tommy Too Much coming from outside the arena. Wow, just to bring you up to speed, those of you who haven't followed, the Washington Bullets and the exotic ones have been feuding for the PWA tag team titles for the better part of 4 months. Looks like Trey Williams of the Bullets and Tommy Too Much of the exotic ones are going to have to work together here. This should be very interesting.
Yeah, I was about to say, Commissioner, you got Somerville and you got Storm. Tremendous fan favorites. And you get one of these bullies out here and the matchup with one of his own hated rivals. It does add not just two, but a third dimension just to this one match alone.
Yeah, I cannot imagine at first glance the exotic one, one of the exotic ones, one of the Washington Bullets being a cohesive unit. We're going to see. Telling Tommy Too Much to hit the road, but he's Trey Williams' tag team partner. Referee Madman Mason. Oh, he's telling John Williams, you got to hit the road, Jack. This is not a normal tag team match.
No, this is not.
Much to his chagrin, he's not liking this at all.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I can promise you I was just as surprised as you are.
John Williams thinking better of it. Apparently he'll have his crack later on. This is what we alluded to, Bert. You see Trey Williams and Tommy Too Much arguing already before the bell.
And there it is right there as they go out for a quick one, and they both get a two count.
It may cost both men there. Irish whip by Stanley Somerville. Stinger Splash. Oh, I shouldn't say Stinger Splash in the corner. We got enough steam copyright infringement tonight. You can see it right there.
Two pass by Somerville. Going for the quick cover.
Too Much going for the tag. Trey Williams saying, but I'm telling you, they're going to have to put personal differences aside if either of these men want to advance to Battle Bowl and have a chance to become the new Heritage Champion. Josh Storm going up top, man.
The double foot to the arm, don't see that much. It's better than the double ass handle, but going with the feet instead. Andre, take over.
Josh Go chant emanating here. This is actually his PWA debut, however, working for UIW and other promotions close in the area. Got quite a following here in the West Georgia. That's what I call him, the local scene.
Somerville on top rope, coming down. This time with a right hand, looks like to the rib cage of Trey.
Yeah.
got to give it to Somerville and Storm. They are working better as a team. As you see a double back elbow. Elbow drops. Somerville once again. I don't, like it was broken up by Storm.
That's what I was trying to, what happened with that?
I don't know if I want to use the term greedy. We've got some hungry individuals here this evening.
I say hungry, yes, but I get a little bit more greedy as the night goes along. First, you have to advance.
Well, I think if they got to work together to get to the 16-man.
Very good point, Cobra. You got to put personal differences aside. I mean, even if it's not even differences, you got to, you know, if you don't know the person, the stranger element here, you got to find a way to work together. Oh, actually some teamwork by Tommy Too Much and Trey Lee.
That was a nice kick.
You can see him kind of coming around here. As if they had worked together before, almost knowing where the other one would be.
Yeah.
Knee into the back. Well, that's far from the case.
I think when your wrestling ethics is that equal to Tony the Cobra, you do things like that, no matter who your partner is.
Well, things happen for to the best of us. And, you know, of course, I'm the best.
So your motto is, it's legal as long as the ref don't see it.
No, you got a five count. One, two, three, four, break your hold in five. You got to know the rules, sir. Know the rules.
It's a double stomp there by Storm. That's about the sixth successful tag between Storm and Somerville. I think there's only been one tag between Trey and Tommy. See a horror Kamana right there by Josh Storm as Trey goes out to the floor. Some shoving going on outside, and that's between teammates.
Oh, wow. They're going at it on the outside. Mason trying to break up teammates. Somerville wants a piece of the action.
That's tag team partners going at it. Somerville's going into the meeting of the heads.
Some of them said, I don't have time for you guys to fight amongst yourselves. Josh Storm is impressive. Well, I'm surprised right there that Tommy Too Much would save Trey Williams. However, he's thinking
Well, you know, what Tommy Too Much had to think about, he can't get to the 16 to become the Heritage Champion if he don't win this match.
Correct. You know, all three of us know this sitting here. We're going to see this all night long. These guys have been sitting back here since at least 5:36 p.m. They don't know who their partner's going to be. They don't know who they're facing.